Hello everyone, in this video we will see what is the difference between one persistent, non-persistent and p-persistent CSMA. So in one persistent CSMA, it will continuously sense channel for transmission of frames. So for transmitting the frames, the stations first check whether the channel is busy or idle. If it observes the channel is busy, then simply it will not wait for any time, again it will sense the channel. So that's why it will continuously sense the channel for transmission of frames. Whereas non-persistent, when the channel is idle, then only it will send the packet. Otherwise it will wait for random amount of time for again sensing the channel. Coming to p-persistent, it will wait for next time slot for transmission of frames. Once it will transmit the frame, next it will not continuously transmitting the frames. It will wait for a time slot, and after that the timer times out, it will start transmitting the next frame. When channel is idle, it will send with probability 1. So in one persistent, it will check the medium. If the channel is idle, then it will start transmitting the packet with a probability of 1. In non-persistent, it will wait for random amount of time to check the carrier. When the channel is idle, it will send with a probability of P. In p-persistent CSMA, simply when the channel is idle, it will send a packet with a probability of P. The delay load is low, then the one persistent is small because frames are sent only in the idle state. So in non-persistent, it is small as station will send whenever channel is found idle, but longer than one persistent since it checks for the random time when busy. So compared to one persistent, in non-persistent, once it will identify the channel as a busy, then simply it will wait for a random amount of time. After that, means after the timer times out, again it will sense the channel. So in this way it will check the medium and transmitting the packets. It is large when probability P is small because station will not send always in idle state of channel. In one persistent, the delay load is high due to collisions. So because in one persistent, more number of collisions will be happen. There is a possibility for occurrence of more number of collisions. So that's why the delay load of one persistent is high. In non-persistent, it is longer than one persistent as channel is checked randomly when busy. It is large in p-persistent when the probability P of sending is small when channel is found in idle state. That means when the channel is idle, the station will start transmitting the packet with a probability of P. That's why it is having a higher delay load. Coming to the utilization. So in one persistent, its utilization is above to the Aloha protocols because frames are sent only when the channel is found in idle state. Coming to non-persistent, its utilization is above to one persistent as not all the stations constantly check the channel at the same time. The channel utilization of P persistent is dependent on the probability P. In one persistent, there are highest number of collisions are observed. Whereas in non-persistent, less chances as compared to one persistent, but more than P persistent. That means the number of chances of collisions are less than one persistent and more than P persistent will be observed in the non-persistent CSMA. Coming to P persistent, there are less chances of collision than in one persistent. Mean when compared to one persistent and non-persistent, the number of chances of collisions are less in P persistent. So these are all the differences of one persistent, non-persistent and P persistent. Thank you.